Hi, kamusta po kayo? Pinagpalang araw po para sa ating lahat at welcome po muli para sa ating snack break time. Cheers! Salamat po ulit sa mga kasama ho natin sa SBC, sa Toyota, sa Mitsubishi at sa iba't ibang mga kumpanya at mga kapatiran sa iba't ibang lugar sa buong mundo. Salamat po sa inyo pong patuloy na pagsubaybay sa ating mga usapin. Ngayon po, we're talking about think anew. As we welcome a new normal, dapat matuto tayo how to forget what lies behind but to look forward to what lies ahead. And the greatest challenge really starts with the mind. Kaya nga po sa pagkakataon na ito, as we think anew, we need to first learn how to think right. Because if you do not think right, you will have nothing left. And for sure, if you think right, you will never go wrong. Kaya napaka-importante po that we need to use our thinking correctly. Kaya ho, when we think anew, forget the bad thoughts, forget the yung mga wrong thinking in the past. We need to change the way we think. Kaya ho, ito yung challenge po sa atin. Even God Himself, when we came to know the Lord, nung nakilala natin si God, o si Jesus Christ, and He promised us a new life. Tinan nyo, sabi niya sa Colossians, set your mind on the things above, not on the things that are on earth. Ang kalaban ho natin ngayon, as we are focusing to the things that we are seeing nowadays, ang dami hong thinking that will bring us to fear, mga palaisipan na nagbibigay ho ng takot sa atin, pag-aalala, pagbibigay ho ng kaguluhan. Pansinin po ninyo, it has something to do with the mind. When we say anxiety, it is divided mind. Kaya ho, napakahalaga ho, how are we to think right? Yun ho ang challenge po sa atin. And when we came to know Jesus Christ, ito pong isang bagay na huwag nating kakalimutan. For who has known the mind of the Lord, that He will instruct him? Sabi niya, but we have the mind of Christ. If you're claiming to be a follower of Jesus, dapat naintindihan mo that you have the mind of Christ. Paano po ba yan? Hindi man natin matatapos yung bagay na yan ngayong araw na ito. But I just want you to understand something about Jesus. Si Jesus po, every time he thinks so clearly kung sino siya. Because the first thing that Satan will do is to question who you are. And oftentimes, for example, when we come to a point na parang, wow, mawawalan na akong trabaho. Teka muna, what do you mean na mawawalan kang trabaho? What do you think who you really are? Your life is not your work. Diba? The work depends entirely on who you are. Kaya napaka-importante yan. Even Jesus Christ, He is God. And yet He knew clearly when He was physically present on earth, alam na alam niya kung sino siya. He would say, I am the bread of life. I am the light of the world. I am the door. I am the good shepherd. I am the resurrection and the life. I am the way, the truth, and the life. I am the true vine. So doon pa lang, alam na alam niya kung sino siya. But the question that we need to answer tayo personally is this, sino ka bang talaga? Well, I am Bong Saquing. No, that's not me. That's my name. Well, I am a preacher. Well, that's your work, but that's not you. Alam nyo, you need to understand first, teka muna, sino ba ako? If I would be stripped of my work, if I would be stripped of my name, for example, I would just be given a number. Sino ako? Yun ang tanong. Diba? Sino ako? Kaya ganun din ang tanong sa'yo, sino ka? If you cannot answer who you are, obviously, you will always be dependent on what people will tell about you. Kaya ho, napaka-importante yun. Kaya maraming tao, their identity is always based on their works, based, kaya na, sa tanungan pa lang di ba? Anong pangalan mo? Anong trabaho mo? But wow, ako po ay ganito. Parang wow, big time. No, yung pong pagkatao mo, hindi yung kinalaman, walang kinalaman yung trabaho mo. Because yung pagkatao mo, yun ang either big time or small time. But if you don't know who you are, obviously, lagi mo ang batayan mo panlabas. Kaya paano nga kung natanggal na yan? Your identity is not based on your spouse. Your identity is not based on who your parents are. Your identity, hindi, sino ka? That's the question. Now, I want you to understand something. When you came to know Jesus Christ, ito isang bagay na diniinan niya kung sino ka. He gave you your identity. Sino ka man talaga because of Jesus? Sino ka man talaga? And I want you to understand something. Ito po ay bigay ni Neil Anderson sa kanyang kanyang aklat na Victorious, parang Victory Over Darkness. At nilagay niya rin to sa Bandage Breaker. Napakaganda po ito sapagkat it helped him to be victorious in his life. And he encourages people to understand who they are in Christ. Para sa ganun, hindi sila nagiging parang alipin ng kanilang mga bisyo, alipin of anything they claim to be addicted with, yung substance, yung mga ganyang bagay, alipin ng mga opinion ng tao. Kasi ang pinaka-importante, yung naglikha sa iyo will tell you who you are. And when Jesus Christ died on the cross for our sin, He tells us what kind of people we are. We are precious in His sight. And alam niyo ba kung gaano ka kahalaga and your worth? It is based on who made you. For example, ang isang kotse, paano wala lamang mamahalin yan? Sino ba may gawa niyan? Wow, di ba? Ano pa? How much are people willing to buy that kind of car? Di ba? Yung presyo niyan, depende magkano handa mong bayaran para dyan. So, isipin ninyo, who made us? God made us. You know, dun pa lang alam mo na kagad how valuable you are. Now, how much is He willing to pay for you and for me? Wow, He gave His own Son, Jesus Christ. That's how valuable we are before God. So remember this. Katulad po ng sinabi ni Neil Anderson. Sabi niya, for example, when he made a table of who we are in Christ, una, we are accepted. We are called the child of God. We are Christ's friends. We have been justified. We've been bought with a price. We belong to God. I am a member of Christ's body. I'm a saint. Can you imagine? I've been adopted to God as God's child. I have a direct access to God through the Holy Spirit. I've been redeemed and forgiven of all of my sins. I am complete in Christ. Can you? Yan ho tayo. Because of Jesus. At hindi lang yon. You and I are secure regardless of what's going on around us. You and I are secure. Bakit? I am free from condemnation. Sabi nga ng Bible, therefore there is now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. I am assured all things work together for good. Wala pong bagay. Lahat ng bagay, masama man o mabuti, but He will work it out for our good if we love God and walk according to His purpose. I am free from any condemning charges against me. I cannot be separated from the love of God. Can you imagine that? And I am a citizen of heaven. Now, sige nga, pag-isipan ninyo. And you know how significant you and I are because of Jesus? We are the salt and light of the earth. We are the branch of the true vine, a channel of His life. We've been chosen and appointed to bear fruit. We are a personal witness of Christ. We are God's temple. We are ministers of reconciliation. So forth and so on. Do you know who you are? Kapatid, if you have not known yet who you really are, why don't you come to the one who created you? Alam niyo, isang malungkot na reality, if you don't believe that we are created by God, then who will tell you who you are? Di ba nakakalungkot yun? You will always be living in assumptions. But why can't you just come and admit, Lord, if You created me, then You know me and You know exactly who I am. And I want to live according to what I am made of, what I am made for. Kaya yun po ang tanong po sa atin. Anong meron sa akin? At ano, saan ako, bakit ako ginawa? Kaya nga, listen to this. Crisis does not make a man. It only shows what man is made of. So remember this. You have the mind of Christ. But do you know who you are? Just as Christ knows who He is. Kaya yun no ang dapat nating pag-isipan. If you want to think anew, then start recognizing who you really are before our Creator, before our God, before the God who loved us and gave Himself up for us. Maraming salamat po sa iyo. See you next week.